हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अजय. वेलकम टू ऑल जर्नीज कैब जर्नी ट्रेनिंग. टुडे वी वांट टू डिस्कस कैब जर्नी प्रीवियस ईयर स्यूडो कोड बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस. सो कमिंग टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे, रीड एक्स इक्वल टू 4, वाई इक्वल टू 0. ओके, सो एक्स इक्वल टू 4 एंड वाई इक्वल टू 0. ओके फाइन, रीड जेड एंड जेड इक्वल टू वाई प्लस 5 एंड वाई. डू रिमेंबर दैट वेन वी हैव समथिंग लाइक वाई कॉमा जेड कॉमा एक्स प्लस प्लस 1 कॉमा 2 कॉमा समथिंग, then if you have a variable at the left, whether it can be zx or something, then the value that's at the rightmost will be copied to the variable. So whatever value present at the rightmost, so suppose if I declare x equal to 0 and in next iteration I give an x equal to 1 2 3, then if we print the value of x, then we get the value as 3, because the rightmost value, whatever this there, this will be the latest value that will be updated to the x. The same way here, z equal to y plus plus comma y means previously y is 0, because of y plus plus it is a post increment, so whenever y is visited again it will be incremented to 1. So z equal to y plus plus comma y, so at this 0, and because y is visited again, so this this becomes 1 and the rightmost value will be copied to z. So we have x equal to 4, y equal to 0 and z equal to 1, and the final statement is right z. So right z means option A, that is z value is 1. Coming to the next question, what will be the output of the following pseudo code? Read ch between 1 and 2, switch ch comma ch plus 1 and 2 means it can be in between 1 and 2. So basically it will be like 1 to 1.9 something. So whatever we are doing, it will be range of 1, so even 1 will be included. So the case 1 will definitely will satisfy. So the moment will case 1 satisfy, it will write 1 means print 1. So the it will print and it will break the switch. So only 1 will be the output, that is option C. Coming to the next question, what will be the output of following input 1 3 4? Okay, this is a recursive function. Let's trace this function of 1 3 4. Okay, here we have 1 3 4, and if num greater than 0, if num greater than 0, yes, 1, 3, 4 greater than 0, a equal to a plus 1. A previously was 0, so a equal to a plus 1 means 1. Next, function of num by 10, that is 134 by 10 means 13. Next, 13 is greater than 0, yes, a equal to a plus 1, 2. Again, divide by 10 means 1. Here, 1 is greater than 0, yes, a equal to a plus 1, okay, then a become 3, and this becomes function of 0, 1 divided by 10, function of 0, and here we are returning a. Returning a means a value is 3, so a 3 will be returned, that will be the output. So and do remember that here you can see the a is in the form of static int a. So what static will does is, whenever we declare this, there will be only one instance of a. So even though you are calling a, if you are using a and declaring a for more number of recursive cycles, even then only one a copy will be created. Whatever we are doing, plus a plus plus a minus, and whatever we are doing, that will affect the original a. So that's why we are incrementing the value of a. If that is not static, at every iteration there will be a new a, and new a will always will be a equal to 1, a equal to 1, a equal to 1, and it will never be incremented to 3. So because of static only, we are the original value is being affected. So that's why at each iteration a value is getting incremented, and finally we have a equal to 3, that is option B as the correct answer. Next question, what is the output of the given pseudocode for input equals 7? Okay, read the value of n. N is given as 7, so let's write it on n equal to 7, and set m equal to 1, okay, m equal to 1, t equal to 0, fine. If m greater than equal to n, 1 greater than equal to 7, no. So go to line 9, sorry, m greater than equal to n, right, 1 greater than equal to 7, no, this condition false, so it will go to else part, t equal to t plus 1, okay, let's write this in a table format, t equal to t plus m means 0 plus 1, this become 1, and m plus equal to 1. M plus equal to 1 is nothing but m equal to m plus 1. This is a shorthand way of representing m plus equal to 1 means m equal to m plus 1. So m equal to m plus 1 means 1 become 2. Next, go to line 3. Line 3 again, if m greater than or equal to n. 2 greater than or equal to 7, no. T is increment to t plus m, 3. And this become 3 again, m equal to n plus 1. Again, 3 is greater than or equal to 7, no. So this become 3 plus 3 is 6, this become 4. So let's write it again here, m, t, 6. At this condition, again check, 4 greater than or equal to 7, no. So 6 plus 4, 10. And here it became 5. Next, it became 15. Here it became 6. 6 is greater than or equal to 7, no. So again, this became 21. And this became 7. And 7, go to line 7. 7 greater than or equal to 7, yes. This become true. Then enough, we have the condition as go to line 9. So go to line 9 is display t. So what is the display t? That is the value of t here, 21. So option D is the correct answer for this question. Come to next question. What is the output of the following pseudocode? Okay, a recursive function. Function of n equal to 2. So function of 2. If n equal to equal to 4, no, n is not equal to 4. Else part 2 into function of 2 plus 1, that is function of 3. Okay, this is done. Next is function of 3 again, 3 equal to equal to 4, no, else part again 2 into function of 3 plus 1, 4. N equal to equal to 4, yes, it's equal. So n equal to 4 means return n, 4. 2 4s are 8, so this completely is returning 8. This is returning 8 means 2 into 8, 2 8s are 16. So this completely is returning 16. So option C is the correct answer for this question. What will be the output of the following code snippet? Okay. Int I equal to 5, j equal to 7, I plus j greater than 5. Okay. I plus j. So it's basically like this is one if, and inside that there is a if else. If this condition satisfied, if this if doesn't satisfy, that is the outer if doesn't satisfy the else part of that outer if. So if this condition satisfy, the inner if else, otherwise the outer if, for the outer if there is a else part here. So if still doesn't understand, it's like if one condition and some statements, and again if one condition, if doesn't satisfy else part, and there is a else part for this if again. So this is the structure how the pseudocode is being represented. So coming to the code, I equal to 5, j equal to 7. Let me erase this everything. Int I equal to 5, j equal to 7. I plus 5 plus 7 is 12. 12 greater than 5. 12 greater than 5, yes, it's true. So j equal to I plus 2. Let's write the previously j, I is 5 and j equal to 7. J equal to I plus 2, I value is 5, 5 plus 2 is 7. So j becomes 7, previously also 7, so though there is no effect, so j is still 7. If j is less than 5, 7 is less than 5, no. So this is not being printed. Else part is, so it goes to else part, print j. J value is 7, that is option C. Option C is the correct answer for 6th question. What will the output of the following pseudocode? Okay, there's an again a recursive function int 5 n equal to 2. Okay, n equals 5. No, so in else part 2 into function of n plus 1, 2 into function of n plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3. Again, 3 is equal to 5. No, so 2 into function of 3 plus 1, 4. Again, 2 into function of 5. Function of 5, it returns 5. So this returns 5. 2 5s are 10. So this completely returns 10. 2 into 10, 20. So this completely returns 20. 2 into 20, 40. So this completely returns 40. So f of 2 is 40. So option D is the correct answer for this. Here, okay, there are certain variables. Beginning equal to 5, end equal to 7, sum equal to 0. Okay. And if beginning greater than end, 5 greater than, no, else for n equal to n. N equal to n means n equal to n, n equal to 7, comma n greater than equal to beginning, beginning is 5, and here n equal to n minus 1. Okay, n equal to n minus 1. So this will execute for each iteration. Fine. Next statement, sum equal to sum plus n. Previously 0, 0 plus n, n is at first 7. So 0 plus 7, this becomes 7. N equal to n minus 1. So this becomes 6. So this becomes 6. So n value now became 6 here. And again in the iteration, so in the next iteration, the n value is getting decremented because of n equal to n minus 1 again here. So 6 becomes 5. We are checking the condition 5 greater than or equal to 5 or not. Yes, it's greater than or equal to 5. So this condition satisfies. Sum equal to sum plus n. Sum plus n, 7 plus 5 is 12. Here n equal to 5. Because of n equal to n minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4. And n equal to n minus 1, this becomes 3 again because of this n equal to n minus 1. So we have n equal to 3. So it can check the condition 3 greater than or equal to beginning, that is 5. No, so this becomes false. So there's the end of loop and print n. So the n value which we have at last is 3. Option D is the correct answer for this. What is the output of the following pseudo code? Input A equal to 8, B equal to 16. Okay, A equal to 8, B equal to 16. A 8, B 16. Fine. Int n equal to 0. If B less than 1, return n. Else, return of A plus B plus 2, comma B minus 2. Okay, so we have a plus b plus 2 comma b minus 2. Fine. Function of a plus b plus 2, sorry, function first we will write this only, a comma b, that is 8 comma 16. Here we are checking b is less than 1, 16 is less than 1, no. So we are actually returning the else part, that is a plus b plus 2. 8 plus 16 is 24, 24 plus 2 is 26, 26 comma 16 minus 2 is 14. Then next iteration again it will not satisfy. 14 plus 5 is 30, 40. 40 comma 12. This way it will just go on until b is less than 1, that is 0. Then at that time we will return the n value. N value is declared as 0, so it will return as 0. So there is a trick for this. If you can observe, we are returning the n value here, and we are declaring n value here only. This is not a static variable. Each time we are declaring, so at each instance n value becomes 0 only, and the n value is not being passed as a parameter also. So whatever the situation is at every instance, if like whenever we are returning n, so it will definitely return 0. So you can blindly say that when you see int n equal to 0 and there is no use of n here and at last we are returning n means, so answer is 0 only. There is no need to traverse a complete recursion. If you traverse a complete recursion, the time will get wasted for this. So there is a trick for that. You just need to observe n equal to 0 is given, so we can directly this program will directly return 0 no matter how many iterations it will pass. So option C is the correct answer for this. Come to the last question for today. What is the output of the given pseudocode for a equal to 100? Okay, a equal to 100, find cont of 100. If a equal to 0, no, else part, return a percentile 10. A percentile means 100 percentile 10 is 0. 0 plus 2 into count of a divided by 10, that is 10. Again this will come, a equal to 0, no, 10 is not equal to 0. So again 10 percentile 10, this is 0 again, 0 plus 2 into count of 10 divided by 10, that is 1. 1 equal to 0, no. Here 1 percentile 10 is 1, 1 plus 2 into count of 1 divided by 10 is 0, equal to 0. So this becomes 0, so this will return 0. So this becomes 2 into 0, 0. So this complete will return 1. 2 into 1 becomes 2. Here 0 plus 2 is 2, So 22, it becomes 4. So this into 2, 2 into 2, this becomes 4. 0 plus 0, and finally it becomes 4. So count of 100 is nothing but 4. Option B is the correct answer for this question. That's it for this video. All the best. Thank you.